Thank you. Good evening. Thank you guys for coming. I'm so happy to have you here. This is my first faculty recital at Cal State Long Beach, and I'm thrilled to share it with you guys. And I have some great music. You've already heard some wonderful pieces, and we have lots more fun to come. This next piece is by Adrienne Albert, who's a composer living in Los Angeles. And I believe, Adrienne, there she is. She's here today. So Adrienne is a wonderful composer, but she started her career as a singer, and she was the soloist, the alto soloist for Stravinsky's Mass. So she actually met Stravinsky and worked with Stravinsky, and Trivia just is super, super cool. She's a really wonderful person. I've had the opportunity to work with her in a masterclass a couple summers ago with Jenny Brandon, where she composed a piece, Gershwinitis, for solo flute. It was all about composing for solo flute. She has later moved to composition after her singing, and has created a great catalog of music for a wide variety of instruments. She was commissioned to write this next piece, Acadian Dreams, to tell the story through music, the history of the Acadian people immigrating from France to Nova Scotia in the 1600s. Longfellow composed this epic poem, Evangeline, based on the Acadian people, and it ends in the contemporary influence of Zydeco music in New Orleans, as many Acadians resettled there in Louisiana and became known as Cajuns. So you'll hear a little bit like jazz and harmonies in there, and some playful, some swing and everything. So please enjoy Acadian Dreams.
Thank you.
now we get to my commercial breaks. Commercial number one, Flute Day at the Beach, March 19th. As my first year as a professor here at Cal State Long Beach, I decided why not have a recital and start a flute day all in the same year and have a baby. Why not? So we're going to have a flute day. It's going to be a wonderful day of tone classes, technique classes, master classes, and then we're going to have performances at the end of the day by our very own CSULB flute choir, which I can see most of them are here, all of them are here in the middle, and lots of ensembles, and then also everyone that comes will have a chance to participate in the all-participant flute choir. So if you register, we can send you some music, you can start practicing now. All ages, all levels. We want everyone to come. My dream is for it just to bring the community of flute players together so that everybody can come together, and it's just going to get bigger and better. But this is our first annual, so we're going to start a little small. So please, Flute Day at the Beach, March 19th. There's flyers in the lobby, I think.
Yes.
Yes, great. Thank you, Michelle. Fantastic. Awesome, awesome. Okay, this next piece is Passage, and it was written by my friend Daniel Kelley for his sister Joyce while she was at school. And now this piece has become kind of a standard in our Piccolo repertoire. It's really lovely. So we're going to play that, and then we will finish the first half with a three-movement sonata by Amanda Harberg, which is just a great showcase piece for the Piccolo. So enjoy these pieces.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
commercial break. Actually, would you mind turning up the house lights for just a minute on this one? I have some super exciting news to share with you that I've been holding in, haven't told anybody, well, maybe a couple people, waiting for my recital to make this big announcement. So, I want to, I have commissioned Jenni Olson, the composer of the last piece and the composer of the next piece, who is here tonight, Jenni Olson. So I have commissioned Jenni Olson to write a concerto for flute and wind symphony to be performed by myself and the CSULB Wind Symphony in the spring of 2025. This piece is going to be a reflection of Cal State Long Beach and also the city of Long Beach. And also, I'm going to dedicate it to John Barcelona, who was the flute professor here for so many years and has established such a wonderful program that I have come into, which I believe he's here also tonight as well. There he is. To give signed copies for a certain amount of money to donate towards the project. So lots more details to come. I've been holding it in. I've been super excited about this. It's been a very, very big, exciting year for me, and I'm so glad to share it with all of you. This next piece is Jenni Olson's second piece. She wrote for me in 2011, and I play it as often as I can. This piece is incredibly evocative and lush. And I had the idea to combine this with video images to make it an even greater experience. My friend Mainred Brennis created this video for us tonight, and it's part of a larger project that I get to perform at the Flute Convention in Phoenix this summer. I was selected to play a recital on Friday night, and I'm going to be playing Dreams of Birds, the Sancan, Gershwinitis by Adrienne Albert, and also Dragonfly, composed by my friend Damian Montano, all with video. So they're all going to be unique videos, and it should be super exciting. So if you want to go to Phoenix in August, please come to my recital. and now for this wonderful piece, Dreams of Birds. These are Jenni Olson's thoughts on the piece. The Dreams of Birds explores the world of what birds might dream. Would they dream of running or flying to the sun? Would they dream of being human? I wanted to explore the possibility of bird dreams while continuing to be evocative of a bird with bird-like songs. The little turns and grace notes, as well as the flutter time effect, offer the listener the voice of the bird. The piano, both supportive and at times grand, helps give flight to these dreams of birds. Thank you. This is my last commercial break. Before we play our final piece this evening, I have one more commercial. I even wrote that down. This summer, there's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for our flute players here at CSELV to go to a summer flute institute in Italy, and it's called CSU Summer Arts. They receive college credit and will have 3 weeks of working with some of the best flute players in the world. There's a lot of scholarship money available to help them with their tuition, but the room and board and plane tickets are obviously a huge expense to get to Italy over the summer. So I am starting a fund, one more thing to do this year, starting a fund to help those that want to go to Italy and need a little financial help. So after the concert, you can see Michelle, raise your hand, Michelle, in the lobby. She has my CDs. If you'd like to buy one of my CDs today, 100% of the profits will go towards this fund to help pay for plane tickets and room and board for anybody in our studio that wants to go to Italy this summer. So there you have it. You can also just make a donation if you prefer your music streaming. Some people don't like CDs anymore, but if you want to hold them, they're out there in the lobby. And one thing that I thought about while I was playing Dreams of Birds is super exciting news is Hannah actually gets to play with me in Phoenix this summer. She's from Phoenix and she was hired to play the other stuff, so she will be there so you can hear us again in summer. And then last but not least, some of my dear friends and their families have created some wonderful treats for you in the lobby. So please join us afterwards to say hello. They've worked really hard and they look beautiful here in the front row. So thank you guys for doing that and we'll see you at the end.
Thank you. Thank you.